The Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center, located on the Presidio of Monterrey, held its 2023 Hall of Fame ceremony to induct four individuals who profoundly influenced foreign language training within the Department of Defense.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Commandant, Colonel...
Among the inductees was the Honorable Ronald S. Moultrie, a DLI graduate currently serving as the Under Secretary of Defense for Intelligence and Security.
Colonel Keevitt will now present Mr. Moultrie with a certificate recognizing his induction into the Hall of Fame. Sir?
Moultrie, a passionate advocate for language proficiency, underscored its crucial role in national security.
When I talk about language, language is really the key ingredient that enables us to provide information to the President of the United States, but more importantly, to protect our warfighters and to protect our people who may be serving in harm's way. Without language, nothing happens. Of course, language is vitally and critically important during times of conflict. And we are seeing that play itself out in multiple places today, unfortunately. In Russia, Ukraine, since February of last year, and since October this year, we see it being played out in Israel, in Hamas, in that crisis there. There are linguists every day. We're providing information to President Biden, to Secretary Austin, and to the leadership of our country, including Secretary of State and others. That's really making a difference. So it helps us in times of conflict. But information and intel from our linguists also help us during times of peace. And what I always say is, probably the most successful conflict that we have ever seen are the ones that never happened.
Joining Moultrie were three distinguished figures. Retired U.S. Army Lieutenant General Eric Wendt, longtime language proficiency advocate. Craig L. Wilson, who significantly expanded DLI programs. And Ronald Thorpe, honoring his late great uncle, U.S. Army Brigadier General Elliot Thorpe, a pioneer of military language training who had the foresight as the third commandant of DLI to implement multilingual training post-World War II.